I want to show you how I made this Daft Punk helmet. Daft Punk is a band that makes music that I don't really listen to. I think I can name about 3 Daft Punk songs. Anyways, they wear these really cool helmets that have changed throughout the years.
Right, and I think my favorite helmet, based solely off of looks, is Thomas's helmet with the LEDs in it. Well, technically I like the newer shape of the Thomas's helmet, like I don't really like that smile, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put LEDs in the newer shape. I'm gonna be doing a little bit of mixing and matching. See, like this. This is really cool.
So this is kind of like 2 projects in one. The first objective is to make the helmet itself, and then I have to figure out how I'm gonna do the LEDs. So this means that later on in the project, I'm gonna have to do some electronics, which is not something I'm super familiar with. But luckily, Adafruit has some example circuits and code that I could get from their website. They also have a 3D model, so I think I'm just gonna print this one.
Once the pieces are printed, I have to glue them together, and then use things like spot putty, filler primer, and lots of sanding to completely smooth it down. Once the whole thing has been printed, assembled, and completely sanded down, I can hit it with some silver spray paint.
Alright, so that's the easy part done. Let us move forward into the great unknown.
So as I said before, this project is going to be loosely based off of the Daft Punk project on the Learn Adafruit site. The main thing I wanted in my helmet was the Bluetooth-controlled LEDs on the front of the helmet and the LED rings on either side. Each of these features is on a separate circuit, so I'm going to focus on them one at a time.
Alright, so the LEDs on the front of the helmet are going to be controlled with an Adafruit Feather 32U4. This is a microcontroller with Bluetooth capability and built-in charging. The circuit's going to be powered with a lithium-ion battery.
The LEDs on the front of the helmet are individually addressable LEDs called NeoPixels. Now, where I start to deviate from the Learn Adafruit guide is in the number of LEDs I use. You could see here that they only went out and back once, but I wanted to completely fill the front visor with LEDs, so I purchased 2 meters of strip. This is the same thing that the 3D printing nerd did with his Daft Punk helmet, which is why I had confidence that this would look good.
Alright, this is a dead simple circuit. It's got 3 wires. Now, I actually forgot to get 3 different colors of wire, so I had used the same color twice. But then again, the circuit is fairly simple, so it shouldn't really matter. Thank you.
Oh, that makes me so happy. That is really bright. But you can't really do much with this, because it goes in a line. We don't like lines. We want to make this into a grid so we could put stuff on it. So that's the hard part. Let's see what we could do. This is what I've managed to do. So when I turn it on, it fades to white, and then it scans in red. It'll make a little happy face, one pixel at a time. And then I wanted to scroll over some text, but it seems to be too large. I think I need 8 pixels, but I only have 5. So I just want to be able to make a font that only needs 5 pixels. And I found a project by Adafruit from 2015. It's a little snowflake thing for a Neo Matrix with the exact board I have. It's fantastic. So basically what I have set up here, I could go right to the app, and I could actually control the color. And you see there it goes to green. This is a big victory for me, because originally I couldn't get the... I could get a matrix going, but I couldn't get the matrix working with the Bluetooth. But this does it for me. This is a big victory, and I'm sure I could reprogram some other stuff. So after this, that's what I'm going to be working on. And look at that. That is 3x3 text. I got a new font to work. Big success, because that was what was really holding me back. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to see if I could get the text into the snowflake code. Yeah, just to see if it works. Progress has been made today, that's for sure. Even though I haven't really changed the background color properly, that is text. Do you see that? Getting a bit of weird text drop effects. But that is a 5-point high font. The text drop issue is figured out. There's one more thing I have to work out. I want to be able to put in some like little eyes or whatever, and all I think what I could do is just replace the snowflakes with like eyes or something. I want to try and to be able to control them with these little arrow buttons here. We're making some really good progress. I didn't think I was going to be able to do this. While I was doing the electronics for this project, I couldn't help but notice that the shape of the helmet I had printed was a little bit off. So to fix this, I reprinted the whole helmet using a more accurate model this time.
Okay, so now I have to set up the LED rings on either side of the helmet. So the Adafruit guide recommends using their 5-volt trinket to control the circuit, but for whatever reason, I just couldn't upload code to it. I made sure I was following all of the instructions on the Adafruit guide and that I was also using USB 2.0, that I had all of the correct drivers installed, and I even tried using a third-party program to help the IDE find the port, but I had no luck. And in a last attempt of desperation, I even tried using a Windows 7 computer to upload code, but I had no luck with that either. So to fix this problem, I avoided the problem by using an Arduino Nano. This circuit is very similar to the last one, the only difference is I have to split the cable with a Y connector to power both of the LED rings at the same time. Now, because I reprinted the helmet, the size of the matrix I need needs to be a little bit bigger, so I have to change my 14x5 matrix to a 20x5 matrix. And then once I finish extending it, I can cut out the visor and glue it in, and then I can install the last of the LEDs. So the helmet's done, but there's one more thing I want to do. So just to complete the look, I want to do the little gauntlets. So all I'm going to do for them is print out the pieces, sand, prime, and paint, and then I'll glue them onto some leather gloves, and then that'll be everything.
Well, that's the end. I know I say this about all of my projects, but I'm super happy with how it turned out. I'm actually pretty surprised how well the chrome paint has stayed on without a clear coat, and how well it reflects everything around it. There's a lot of methods I considered for doing the chrome, but this was the best result for the lowest cost, and I would definitely use this paint again. I don't know if the black gloss coat underneath was really necessary, but I figured I should put it on just to be safe. If I did this helmet again, I would use the Bondo that you mix yourself to fill in the gaps, because this pre-mixed stuff left a visible line on the helmet. This hasn't happened on any of the projects where I used this Bondo. Something I also would have changed is the scaling. This model was printed at 80%, and this one was printed at 100%. One is too small and the other is too big, so I think the sweet spot is around 90 to 95%. I also would have adjusted the size of the inset for the LED rings so they fit in a little bit better. In the future, I think it'll be cool to do some more experimenting with Arduinos and also these pre-built matrices from Adafruit. When I started coding the LEDs, I began by trying to imitate some of the things that the 3D printing nerd did with his Daft Punk helmet from a few years ago. I did get in touch with him to see if he had his original code, but he did look and couldn't find anything. This was actually beneficial because it forced me to go out and learn how to do some things. Also, a quick thank you to some of the people on the Adafruit forums for helping me out with the scrolling text. Alright, well, this brings us to the end of the video. I want to thank you for watching, and if you like this video, then be sure to hit the like button, and if you want to know where more videos like this are made, then be sure to hit subscribe. Until then, I'm Nate Teb, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.